I'm officially announcing my retirement from the NFL and as a quarterback of the Buffalo Bills.
The Kelly years come to a close. Good evening, I'm Kathleen Layton.
And I'm Keith Ranford. Our top story at 5 o'clock tonight, the passing of an era, the Jim Kelly years, the greatest years in Buffalo Bills history, ended as of today. We have team coverage for you tonight. We will hear from Jim Kelly himself, who said a tearful farewell to his playing days today out at Orchard Park. We'll also take a look back and show you how he changed the team and Western New York. And we will also introduce you to Jim Kelly's number one fan. But first tonight, Eyewitness Sports Director John Murphy here in the studio. He begins our team coverage.
Well, you know, there's never been a day quite like it in the 37-year history of the franchise. There have been wins and losses and trades and signings. There have been a lot of retirements. But when the franchise all-time quarterback made his retirement official today, it was a day to remember in the life of the Buffalo Bills.
The cavernous Ralph Wilson Fieldhouse, filled with anticipation, filled with media, Bill's staff, and Jim Kelly's teammates. Kelly himself, surrounded by his family and the Bills' top brass, ready to make the big announcement.
And now at this time, I'm officially announcing my retirement from the NFL and as a quarterback of the Buffalo Bills.
Kelly's speech was full of emotion, full of warm memories of games and accomplishments.
I'm so proud of what this team has accomplished during my 11 years as a quarterback of the Buffalo Bills. Four straight AFC championships, four Super Bowl appearances, and six AFC East championships.
I guess, there's the old saying, that song, thanks for the memories. But I truly thank you for all you did for the Buffalo Bills and wish you the greatest success.
Over this past 10 years plus has been the heartbeat of the Buffalo Bills. He's been the heartbeat of this team.
Jim Kelly stressed that he went out on his own terms, and he's already spoken to network sports departments about working with them in the future. But it was the past, not the future, on the minds of those inside the field house.
I think it's real special when you can say there was one guy that threw to you that you just knew him like the back of your hand.
There's been a great ride. And while I do agree with the many who have said that this is an end of an era, but to me, it's not an end. To me, my life is just beginning.
Keith, Kathleen Kelly retires. He's near the top in most of the league's statistical categories for quarterbacks. But, of course, his legacy as he retires is really the trigger man, the catalyst for the great football renaissance here in Buffalo over the last 10 years.
Great ride while it lasted,
sure.
Wasn't it?
Yep.
Yeah. All right. Thanks, John.
Many of us will never forget when Jim Kelly became a Buffalo Bill, and certainly we will never forget the great moments of his career. Many of those memorable moments happened at Rich Stadium. John Burton continues our team coverage.
In 1986, Jim Kelly arrived at the Buffalo Airport, complete with a flock of limos. He wasn't a rock star, but he was being hailed as the savior of the Buffalo Bills.
I feel that they definitely are just a few players away from having a great team, and I just want to be a part of it. I've never been on a losing team, and I don't plan on being. And whatever I can do, you know, like I said before, I'm going to give 100%.
September 7th, 1986, Rich Stadium. Kelly's first game as a Bill. Buffalo lost to the New York Jets that day, but Kelly showed signs of good things to come as he almost led the Bills to an upset win.
We came out losing in. But I told everybody after, I said, hey, keep your heads up high. I said, we played a good team today. We're definitely going to win a lot of games this year.
Throughout his career, Kelly showed remarkable toughness in leading the Bills to several thrilling comeback wins. Few will ever forget his two-yard TD plunge on the game's final play to give Buffalo a three-point win over the hated Dolphins back in 89. A year later, Kelly became the league's top-rated passer as he led the Bills to the first of four straight Super Bowl appearances. The first one, a heartbreaking one-point loss to the Giants in Tampa.
It was never meant to be. It hurts. Scotty's won so many games for us, you can't blame him.
Kelly helped lead the Bills back to the big dance the next three consecutive years, but he threw only two touchdown passes and seven interceptions in those three games combined. 1996 was by far his worst year as a pro, throwing only 14 touchdowns and 19 interceptions. Kelly's poor play had most people questioning his abilities, including himself.
I set the urgency on myself to either get it done or get out there and let Todd take over.
Kelly Kelly's season ended by getting knocked out of the AFC wildcard game against Jacksonville with a concussion. The Bills lost the game 30-27, and 2 days later, Kelly's future was up in the air. But he did give an indication of what he'd like to do.
I would love to retire Buffalo Bill. My heart has always been here. I couldn't see playing for anybody else.
And as Jim Kelly walks away from both Rich Stadium and the Buffalo Bills, it'll be interesting to see where his place in NFL history will be.
And that was John Burton reporting. The question now, is Kelly worthy to be inducted into the Pro Football Hall of Fame? Bob McEwen will try to answer that question later tonight on Eyewitness News at 6.
Well, if you think way back 20 years before the Kelly era began, the Buffalo Bills were quarterbacked by the name of a guy called Jack Kemp, who led the team to two titles in the old AFL. Of course, Kemp has gone on to success in other fields, including politics. We met with him today at his office in Washington, and I asked this retired quarterback his thoughts on the day Jim Kelly retired.
A great guy, a courageous quarterback, and probably soon will be not only on the Wall of Fame with Billy Shaw and Tom Sestak and Ralph Wilson and Jack Kemp and Lou Saban, but he's going to be in the Hall of Fame. It's my prediction. He'll be in the Hall of Fame in Canton, Ohio within a few short years.
Now, needless to say, we spoke with Kemp about quite a few issues today, including his political future, and you'll be able to see our one-on-one interview with Jack Kemp coming up next Thursday and Friday night on Eyewitness News at 11. Kathleen?
During his career in Buffalo, Jim Kelly has raised more than $1 million through his Kelly for Kids Foundation. There is one Kelly fan who can tell you firsthand about the kind of charity he has witnessed from his friend, Jim Kelly. Eyewitness News reporter Steve Boyd continues our team coverage.
Outside of Jim Kelly's immediate family, Ron Smith is probably his number one fan. Ronnie is 36 years old, mildly retarded, and when he's not working at Tops 3 days a week, he spends a lot of his time at Rich Stadium. As you can see from his card collection and the decor of his bedroom, Ron Smith loves Jim Kelly.
I cried when I got injured. I was sitting up. I get tickets for every game.
Yeah.
When Jim got injured a couple years ago, I cried.
Yeah.
I told my buddy to leave me alone.
One of Ronnie's best friends is Jim Kelly himself. 2 years ago at Christmas time, Kelly offered Ron a limousine ride because Ron's bike was in such bad shape. Ron said no.
I don't think so. So he told me to come back after a game. And he gave me a bicycle, a 6-speed.
These days, Ron wears a cast on his leg because he was hit by a bus while riding that bike earlier this month. Jim Kelly couldn't retire from football without his pal, so he called the Smith House this morning and sent a driver to bring Ronnie to the announcement.
And now at this time, I'm officially announcing my retirement from the NFL. And as a quarterback of the Buffalo Bills.
As difficult as it was for Jim Kelly to utter those words, it was equally difficult for Ronnie Smith to hear them. But Jim Kelly says he's not leaving Western New York, so Ronnie is not losing his friend.
Oh, there you are. I was wondering where you were, buddy.
Hang on, bud.
What are you doing later?
Thanks for the memories.
Yeah. What are you doing later?
What am I doing later?
Yeah.
Well, big trick. Well, big trick. Get some,
wings.
Some N.A. You want some N.A.?
He's number one.
Chicken
okay. Lots of people say he's no good, but I say he's my best, the best quarterback in the NFL. I'll miss him.
In Orchard Park, Steve Boyd, Eyewitness News.
Our team coverage of the Kelly years will continue on Eyewitness News at 6. We will hear from you, the fans, on your memories of the Jim Kelly era.
It's official. The Jim Kelly years with the Buffalo Bills are history. We have team coverage. We'll hear Jim's emotional retirement announcement. We'll talk with Bills fans and get their reaction. And we'll look at Jim Kelly's involvement with charities and the profound impact he's had on children. Our team coverage begins with Eyewitness Sports Director John Murphy. Murph?
Well, Irv, there were tears and there was emotion on stage at Rich Stadium at noon today when Jim Kelly announced his retirement. But there was also pride, understandable pride, as the greatest quarterback in Buffalo Bills history decided that his time was over.
And now at this time, I'm officially announcing my retirement from the NFL and as a quarterback of the Buffalo Bills. It has been a great ride, and while I do agree with the many who have said that this is an end of an era, but to me, it's not an end. To me, my life is just beginning.
And that's the way the most glorious years of Buffalo Bills football came to an end today. Hundreds of media, about one dozen teammates, the entire Bills office staff, and many others crowded into the Ralph Wilson Fieldhouse as the trigger man for the Bills' Super Bowl run decided to step aside. Kelly maintains the decision was his, a decision reached after consultation with his family.
And I told them that I was thinking on the words of retiring, that I had to spend more time with my family and let the record show that, no, I was never offered a contract, because I never asked for one.
As for his future, Kelly is already talking to the networks about sportscasting. He's building a home in Virginia where he will eventually wind up. But no matter where he goes, Kelly will go with plenty of fond memories of his 11 years in Buffalo.
I'm going to miss the camaraderie in the locker room. I'm going to miss messing with those guys just like they mess with me. I'm going to miss going to training camp. And believe me, I've always looked forward to training camp.
I think it's real special when you can say there was one guy that threw to you that you just knew him like the back of your hand. And, you know, Jim was that guy for me.
No player I've ever coached is tougher. No one has ever been the prototype quarterback to the degree that Jim has in terms of leadership.
Well, what about Jim Kelly's place in NFL history? Bob McEwen takes a look at that coming up in sports. Irv, it was a momentous day for the Buffalo Bills.
Okay, today. Thank you very much, John. Yep.
Well, without doubt, the most watched television program at noontime today was the Jim Kelly News Conference, carried live by News Channel 7. Eyewitness News reporter Susan Banks continues our team coverage with fan reaction to Kelly's retirement announcement. Susan.
Irv, I was just thinking about how cool it is to see ourselves on all these big TVs. I'm at Damon Sports Bar and Restaurant on Sheridan Drive in Amherst. Everybody's just seeing themselves now. You know, I was trying to count, or maybe it would be impossible to count the numbers of people who watched Jim Kelly play football in sports bars like this over the last 11 years. Today they sat here and watched him say goodbye to football.
They knew it was coming, as did Jim Kelly, but the news conference finalized it, and there would be no turning back.
I tell you one thing, I can feel for him and everything that he's experiencing making that announcement.
Ernie Warlick, number 84, retired from the Bills in 1965. He says he'll have some advice for Jim Kelly.
The guy's phenomenal. He was just phenomenal. But I can tell him that in about 7-8 years from now, all the aches and pains he's going to have, because I'm suffering them right now.
The Kelly retirement brought back memories for Ernie and for fans, too.
One of the greatest moments I was thinking about Jim Kelly was when he wasn't on the field, when he was rooting for Frank Reich in that great comeback game. And I thought, you know, here he was, and he was still a part of the team, maybe even more so, helping those guys on the sideline to come back. And so that's one of the, you know, the best memories I have of Jim Kelly.
As they have for the last decade plus one, fans are still rating Jim Kelly's performance.
Everybody should have to see that to pump everybody up and to make you feel like you could totally get through something.
Others said he went out with class, and one woman who clearly has reached retirement age herself had some advice for Jim. She said, it's not the end of your life, it's the beginning of your life. Susan Banks reporting live from Sheridan Drive in Amherst. Back to you, Irv.
Thank you very much, Susan. Well, Jim Kelly's exploits on the football field are well known, of course, but there have also been his many contributions to the Western New York community, particularly children's charities. Our team coverage continues with the Eyewitness News reporter Brian Cale.
No Buffalo athlete did more for kids than number 12. His Kelly for Kids Foundation raised more than $1 million. His annual golf tournament brought big stars and raised big money. Add his annual football camp for young players who dreamed of the big time. And Cradle Beach Camp received more than $500,000 from Kelly for Kids. The recipients of Jim Kelly's goodwill were understandably concerned that the end of his playing days might be the end of his commitment to this community. But today, Kelly made it clear that's not the case.
I will still be a part of Buffalo. I'm still going to have my Kelly for Kids golf tournament. I'm going to still try to raise money for the kids that are a lot less fortunate than ourselves. I'm still going to have my football camp here. I will still be a part of Buffalo.
Kelly's words were music to the ears of Judge Penny Wolfgang, a member of the board of the Kelly for Kids Foundation.
I'm pleased but not surprised, because he's been so dedicated to the Kelly for Kids Foundation and to raising money for these charitable and good causes, especially involving young people.
It's clear that number 12 will be missed by an awful lot of people, including, of course, his teammates and the fans. But Jim Kelly touched and improved the lives of an awful lot of children during his years here. That's part of his legacy, too, and it appears, for now at least, that part will go on.
Reporting from the Ralph C. Wilson Fieldhouse, Brian Cale, Eyewitness News.
Stay with us for a special look at the Kelly years, coming up at the end of this news program. Still ahead on Eyewitness News, it's retired, but Murph says he's not going to be sitting on the back porch reading Modern Maturity magazine.
No, probably
right?
Not.
You're right about that. So what does lie ahead for Jim Kelly, the all-time quarterback who called it quits today? Well, he's talking about working in broadcasting, and he's talking about eventually moving to a home under construction in Virginia. Kelly stays on as a paid consultant with the Bills, too. About one dozen of Kelly's teammates were on hand for today's retirement announcement, a decision that leaked out 1 week ago. We asked today if, one, Kelly's decision is final, and, two, what caused him to retire at this time?
Number one is, no, I will not play in the National Football League anymore because I wanted to retire Buffalo Bill. Number two is, I sat down with Mr. Wilson and Coach Levy, and they asked me what I wanted to do. And I told them I needed some time to think about it. And we spoke on terms, and you really can't go into detail over everything, but I needed some time to spend with my family.
Kelly stressed today the decision to step down was his. The Bills did more winning, and the fans had more fun in Jim Kelly's 11-year reign than at any other time in franchise history. But how will pro football historians treat Jim Kelly? More specifically, will he be a Pro Football Hall of Famer? Bob McEwen has more on that.
Now that Jim Kelly's career is over, the big question is, will the best quarterback in franchise history ever be inducted into the Pro Football Hall of Fame?
He definitely knows that he's going to the Hall of Fame. You know, he's been one of the toughest quarterbacks to ever play in this league. And, you know, I don't know whether it be his first time or his second time, but sooner or later, you know, Jim will be in the Hall of Fame.
During those Super Bowl runs, we did that with a lot less defense than we've had the last couple of years, and it all fell on his shoulders, and I hope that the people will look at that.
Kelly's stats warrant a place in the Hall. In his career with the Bills, he's thrown for over 39,000 yards and 258 touchdowns. In all time in the NFL, Kelly ranks 8th in completions, 10th in passing yards, 12th in TD passes, and 13th in pass attempts.
Forget about the statistics. He has those, but there are so many intangibles. You know, he's definitely a Hall of Fame quarterback.
If you played well enough and you've been supported with a great supporting cast like I have been in the years past, you hope that one of these days that there are people out there that will recognize it's just not one person. It takes a team in order to achieve certain goals, and hopefully I've done enough to be able to put my name in with some of the greats.
There's no doubt that Jim Kelly's name will appear on the Bills Wall of Fame sometime in the future, and Kelly's stats and Kelly's teammates say that he should be in the Hall of Fame in Canton, Ohio as well. At Rich Stadium, Bob McEwen, Eyewitness Sports.
Kelly would be eligible for election to the Hall of Fame in 5 years. There is NFL news from New England today, where Bill Parcells officially stepped down as coach of the Patriots.
I'm Matt Smith from Western Bowl. A very important chapter in Buffalo Bills history closes, and come fall, new chapters will be written. But for now, the best of luck to Jim Kelly in the next chapter of his personal life. Be sure to watch Keith and Kathleen at 11. Have a good weekend. We'll see you Monday night at 6.
And now, the end is near. So I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear. I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I fit all.
a man enough to realize that if you can't get it done, I don't care what position you're playing. If you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing out there, maybe move on to something else.